Hello guys, and welcome to C programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the basic structure of C programming language. And today in this tutorial, we are writing our first program, that is to print a message "Hello World" on the screen. Before starting the program, we need some tools to write the program as well as execute the program. That is, we need a text editor to write our program. We can use any editor like Notepad, Notepad++, WordPad in Windows, or you can use gedit or any other editor in the Linux environment. And second is, we need a compiler. As we know, C is a compiled middle level language. To convert that middle level language to machine code, we need a compiler. In this tutorial, we are just writing our program. In the next tutorial, we'll see how to run this program. As I said, in this tutorial, we are writing only program, so we need a text editor. About the compilers, we'll discuss in the next tutorial. As I said previously, you can use any editor. I'm in Windows, so I'll use Notepad. And here we go. We already know the basic structure of C programming language. That is this. We can see the different sections, right? In that, first section is the documentation section. This section will give documentation to all the readers, or we can say it contains all the information about the programs, but all the informations are commented. But here, Hello World program is a simple program, and I don't want to include any documentation to this program, so I'll skip this part. Okay, and the next section is link section. That is, in the link section, we can mention the header files. So we need this. Okay, in our program, we are printing a message "Hello World" on the screen, so we want "Hello World" as output. So to get output, we need to use the output function. Okay, and these output functions are declared in some header file. So to use that output function, we need to include header file in our program. That is, there will be a library. Okay, in that, many header files will be there. And for example, stdio.h, this is an header file, or math.h, or we can say stdlib.h. Here we can see each file has .h extension, that tells that it is a header file. And this header file contains many function declarations. For example, stdio stands for standard input output, so it contains input and output function declaration. In C, output function is printf and input function is scanf, that we'll discuss later. For now, we need an output function, that is printf. We are using printf in our program, and this printf is declared in the standard input output header file. So to use this function, we need to include this header file in our program. Okay, so first line of my program is hash include and lesser than symbol stdio.h greater than symbol. Okay, here hash include is a preprocessor directive, and we'll discuss this topic later. For now, just remember that when the compiler see this statement, it will copy the contents of this header file to our program. Okay, this is in the link section, and the next section is the definition section. In the definition section, we can define any symbolic constant, but I don't want any symbolic constant in my program, so I'll skip this. Next is global declaration section, where you can declare an user defined function or global variables. And I don't want any global variable, or I'm not using any user defined function here, so I'll skip this also. So next section is main section. And main, and it contains open curly brace and closed curly brace. Here main is a function. Each function returns some value. For example, if square root is a function, if we give input as 2, then it will give output as 4, right? So it returns some value. In same way, main functions also return some value, and main always returns integer value. Here we need to include the return type of main function, that is int. So int space main. Okay, so this is the return type here, this is the function name, and here we can see open curly brace. As I said in the previous tutorial, from here actual execution starts, and this is the closed curly brace, here actually execution ends. In the main function there will be two part, right? One is declaration part, another is execution part. In the declaration part you can declare any local variable, and in this program we don't want any local variable, so we'll skip that part also. So next part is execution part, and here we want to print a message to the screen. As I said, for that we'll use output function, that is printf followed by the parenthesis, inside that double quotes, and here you can write your message, that is hello world, okay, and semicolon, because in C semicolon is statement terminator. And next, as I said, similar to the other function, main also returns some value, and this value called as exit status of our program, that is return 0. Here 0 is for success and semicolon. Okay, next is the user defined section. As I said, we are not using any user defined function, so I'll skip that section. So now we are done with our programs, so we need to save this program. For that, just go to the file and save. Here you can select the location, that is I want to save my program in desktop, so desktop, and here we can see file name, so you can give any name. I'll give first .c. Here .c is the extension for C files, and here save as type as all files and save. Okay, now we are done with our program, and in the next tutorial we'll see how to run this program in our system. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.